Coming up, the latest on business applications, especially enterprise resource planning in the cloud with Microsoft Dynamics AX. We're going to take a look at the latest user productivity updates, including the new user interface, new experiences such as workspaces and task guides, and real-time and also interactive insights with Power BI. And keep watching, because if you're in IT, we're going to take a look at native integration with Visual Studio and how data management gets even easier. By Sri Srinivasan, General Manager of the Dynamics AX Platform team. Welcome.
Great to be here.
So we've seen some huge improvements with Dynamics AX recently releasing, but what's been your focus?
Our focus has been getting Microsoft Dynamics AX and its functionality to the cloud. Mm-hmm. We are proud to bring amazing user experiences today. And at the heartbeat of any organization is business process. And our focus has been speeding up businesses.
So what's new with this release?
Dynamics AX is powered by the cloud. With Dynamics AX 2012, we built a lot of industry functionality. Mm-hmm. The industry functionality around retail, distribution, professional services, manufacturing is brought together in this new cloud experience. It's further amplified by the Azure tooling around big data, machine learning, modern experiences, embedded analytics, real-time capabilities that basically power that user experience. Not only that, we have an extensibility platform, which today brings together close to 50 ISVs that ship with us on the Azure Marketplace. They get deployed through the Azure Marketplace. And as you can see, not only do we have these great organizations available for you to deploy, we have another 200 waiting to jump on the bandwagon. So we're super excited about bringing them on.
Great. So you've mentioned modern user experiences a couple times. Can we see what that looks like?
Absolutely. Let's jump right into one of the modern user experiences. It is a beautiful HTML5 cross-device, cross-browser experience that's composed of a number of icons. Each of these icons represents a workspace. A workspace is an aggregation of tasks that an end user has to perform.
Okay.
And let's scroll into one of these workspaces, the one that's called Sales Order Processing and Inquiry. It is an end user who processes sales orders. As you can see, he has pretty much all the information they need to perform actions. It's including unconfirmed sales orders, delayed sales orders, things that are partially shipped. They have all the information they need to perform their daily tasks. Mm-hmm. Not only that, I'm showing you a reservation management canvas where it shows current rentals, overdue rentals, as tiles. That information is also shown in grid format. And as I scroll this window, you will see analytics powered by in-memory or Power BI show up. So this analytics is ready and available for the reservation clerk. They know which vehicles are earning them the most, which vehicles are pending rental, which vehicles are not getting picked up by organizations. Mm-hmm. So that the business process gets optimized.
And it's great to see the Power BI being pulled right in context. So you see the grid and the tiles from Power BI right there within Dynamics AX. But what if I'm new? What if I've just started my role? You've done some work there around making it easier to get started, right?
Yeah, we talked about the concept of task guides. So let's jump right into one of these. So on the far right, you see a series of steps. Mm-hmm. It's a task guide. Mm-hmm. Normally, in an organization, you see it as a document. Mm-hmm. It's an embedded document. Think of it as training wheels for an end user.
Right.
So I start this task guide. Immediately, it pops up with a first set of instructions. It basically says, hey, go to a particular location. It's asking me to go to accounts receivable, which I shall dutifully do here. I click on all sales orders. It gives me the next set of instructions.
It makes a nice wiggle to show that
absolutely.
You've done the right thing. Yep.
I click new. It's going to give me my next instruction, which is to pick a customer. So I hit the drop-down. I pick Contoso San Diego. It goes right next to hit OK. So so you get the concept. The concept is I record a series of steps as an IT pro, replay them for my end user to consume my business applications on a much easier scale.
So very easy to get started. And I came from a background of building these types of apps out. And I know a lot of companies don't just start with the default settings for maybe your sales flow that you just showed there. How would I actually start customizing that?
Absolutely. So let's start with lifecycle services first. Mm-hmm. For an IT pro, it's important to have a good deployment experience, to have all the systems needed mm-hmm. To develop easily, to configure easily, to make that business application so much more consumable.
Right.
So what we are going to start with is lifecycle services, which is a cloud-based service that encompasses project management, environment management, health management of systems. Mm-hmm. What you're seeing here is methodology for running your project, a set of environments that are ready and available. Let's create one of the one environment here.
Okay.
So I'm going to create a dev test environment in Azure. It's called develop. I pick up configuration mm-hmm. In central US, and I easily, quickly specify how many build boxes I need, what configuration of build boxes, how many developer boxes I need. Mm-hmm. I've already pre-provisioned some of these environments. Mm-hmm. So let's go right into a dev test environment here with all the information available for me to start my development work,
okay.
which makes it easy. I'm going to RDP by clicking into one of those developer boxes.
Right.
That has been pre-provisioned for me.
So straight from the portal gives
straight
you a link.
The portal.
It just downloads that RDP file.
Yeah,
and you're
downloads
right
the
in.
RDP file. I click OK, and I will go into my Visual Studio configuration experience as an IT pro.
So this dev test environment already has even the dev tools loaded in it, so you can start
Absolutely.
Building solutions. Okay.
It has all the Azure tools you need
right.
to build an IT configuration. So right here, I'm in Visual Studio. Mm-hmm. I'm going to pick one of those user experiences. Let's say, you know, the form that models vendors. I'm going to open it up here. And in a beautiful WYSIWYG experience, that form will light up
okay.
for you.
Yep.
So it's not only code management. It's also see it as you build. So if I, for example, click on vendor account, it will go right into the metadata for it. If I switch into, say, registration number, it should switch into information for registration number, so I know where I am as it relates to both the user experience as well as the metadata at all times. I can look at my own configurations that I have done by just typing C colon on top. It shows me highlighted where the changes are, mm-hmm. And it helps me. And if you remember the task guide experience,
yeah.
we can create those. We can take those task guides, import them as XML, and make them a test script that will run in VSDS. And it becomes part of your regression suite so that your solution is whole at all times as you configure and build.
So really great news from an IT pro standpoint. Not only has it provisioned a fully working environment with all the machines and all the services I need, but it's also enabled test automation using those task guides that we saw earlier. Okay, so now we've got our environment. We've got the empty vessel, so to speak. How do I get my data into that new dev test environment?
Most organizations have this problem of data quality, so mm-hmm. we've invested ourselves quite a bit. Let's jump right in. Here's a company called ABC2. I'm in the all customers page, and mm-hmm. you see there are no customers.
Right.
What I'm going to do is I have a data package. Customer is one part of it. There's an Excel spreadsheet of customers.
Okay.
Let's look at the process of bringing these customers into AX.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So I'm going to switch in as an IT pro into one of the data management workspaces, mm-hmm. The workspace I live in as an IT pro. I'm going to import data in here. Let's call it ABC3. It's a package of information that I have pre-created. It's called for this company. Let's look at customers in particular. It's created a visual map for you mm-hmm. of that Excel map to customers in AX. So it's a beautiful visual map. As an IT pro, all you have to do is, for example, if I have to make changes here, I click on this, I drag and drop and manage my mappings.
Right.
What I'm going to do is I'm going to start the import of this data into AX,
mm-hmm.
and it starts the import process.
So in here, you get a nice visual of the progress while it's importing that data. We saw earlier even the relationship mapping already done.
Yeah, so you get a nice visual as the data gets loaded,
mm-hmm.
and as you can see, the load is complete. All the records are inserted. It gives me a nice visual for completion. What I'm going to do is go back into all customers, remember, and see if the data is now available for me to transact. As you can see, the data in the spreadsheet is ready and available for the business process to consume.
So one of the things I remember from working in ERP is really the data cleansing to get some of my older data into the newer solution. Have you made that better?
Absolutely. So right in that data management workspace, mm-hmm. we've built in data quality services, which allow us to do simple things like side-by-side comparisons.
Okay.
On the left side, I have the staging data what you saw in that spreadsheet in a grid format, and it has some amount of validation, so there are no errors in the staging data, in the Excel data itself.
Right.
On the right side, you have data in the customer table itself. This is a customer entity we're talking about.
Mm-hmm.
So I can switch from one customer to the other, and as you can see, it toggles, and you can do side-by-side compares and make sure your data looks right. In today's world, what ends up happening is this data is cleansed by consultants using scripts, using Excel. What we are doing now with these tool sets is we're providing power to the IT pro to manage the data cleansing process through user experience, through validation embedded in the application itself. Quite powerful.
It's really great to see all the different advancements, the culmination of all the cloud technologies making data management easier, the user experiences, but where's this all going?
Yeah, super excited about this release.
Mm-hmm.
And it's a journey. So we are in an age of continuous learning. Mm-hmm. Continuous learning through telemetry, through usage, and basically having that usage drive our priorities in making better productive experiences for end users and tools for IT pros to make their lives so much easier.
So it's really great seeing all these updates. And of course, if you want to learn more about Dynamics AX, check out the link below. It's about all the time we have for today's show. But of course, if you want to keep up to date with the latest technologies from Microsoft, keep tuning in to Microsoft Mechanics. Thanks for watching, and goodbye for now.